you describe the things that have changed since your journey in Portugal first started to where you are today? How's the country
changed? Wow, the change has been a big one, a very big one. When we arrived in Portugal 14 years ago, the road systems weren't in place. The school system needed a lot of work. Medical hospitals were old, really overworked and old. The city of Lisbon was one of those places that was dirty. It was my first impression of Lisbon when I arrived in Lisbon, was that it was black with soot, and you know, for the exhaust fumes of the cars. Most cars in those days used to use diesel, which is very much a Portuguese preferred to use diesel. And what's happened progressively over the last 14 years is that they've slowly started to clean up these places. The government also took a strategic decision in making the country beautiful for tourism. And when I'm talking about the country, not only Lisbon, and local councils all over the country realized the importance of, one, rather than going down the route of creating a resort country, creating what they refer to as the real Portugal. In other words, taking pride in their heritage. So what have you found? You found that in villages where 12 years ago pavements were in tar or cement, they have pulled them up and put down the old cobblestones, because that was the beauty of Portugal. The result being inadvertently creating a whole lot of labor, because it's a manual job. So buildings are cleaner. Most certainly, people's pride of ownership. People are just more prouder of their properties. They're now looking after their properties. The road systems are superb. Superb. It's the experience that all clients have when they come across. It's just how good these roads are. Wonderful. We most certainly have the road system to serve us for the next 40 or 50 years in place. So the country's changed a lot. Culturally not. Culturally it's still this wonderful, real Portuguese experience. But it's also become a country technology for the Portuguese, because in a way they had the advantage of having been the last in this line of progress. They were able to learn from other countries' mistakes or learn from the experience of other countries. So today our internet system works perfectly. Our banking system is fully electronic. Our relationship with the state in terms of bureaucracy, in terms of registrations and things like this, is quick and much, 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 much simpler. A much easier country to work. It's not 12, 14 years ago for me to meet a foreign person living in Portugal, working in Portugal. It was quite rare for me to find. Today, I regularly meet people who, with the benefit of the internet, live in Portugal while they still maintain offices in the countries in which they come from. And this is considered to be perfectly normal today.